So nutrition is basically the process of obtaining food. Okay?
Yes.
So it is the process of obtaining food
Okay.
or getting food. Okay? Now, the nutrition can basically be of main two types. One is known as the autotrophic nutrition.
And the heterotrophic.
Exactly. Now, what do you understand by auto?
Sir, autotrophic means that the body can do its nutrition on its own and not be
Exactly.
dependent on it and perform all the processes on its own.
Yeah. Auto means self, meaning it can make its own food. It can make its own food. ठीक है. And here the example is what? The green plants. The green
Yes.
plants can make their own food by the process of
Photosynthesis.
perfect. Okay. Now, heterotrophic nutrition is directly or indirectly dependent upon what for food?
Sir, other plants or other animals.
Exactly. It is directly or indirectly dependent on the other autotrophs or heterotrophs for food. ठीक है. Now we come to, in the heterotrophic nutrition, we come to the first type of heterotrophic nutrition, which we can term it as our saprophytic nutrition. Now, what do you understand by the term saprophytic nutrition?
Saprophytic means to feed off someone else's.
It depends upon dead
Dead
and
tissue.
exactly, it depends upon dead and decaying tissues, organic matter. For example, fungus, bacteria, they are all saprophytes. Okay.
Yes.
The next one is a parasitic nutrition. What is a parasitic nutrition?
Sir, to steal someone else's food, energy, etc.
Exactly. It depends upon the host for food, like the lice on our head. The lice takes the blood from our body and then it takes the food from that blood. The worms that stay in our digestive system, those worms take in the digested food. The food that we digest is taken by those worms and they get the food. So that is parasitic nutrition.
Yes.
Then there is one more type of nutrition. What is that type of nutrition?
Sir, saprophytic, parasitic, and holozoic.
Okay. Am I missing any other nutrition?
No, sir.
Now, holozoic nutrition is the nutrition that requires digestion. Okay. This requires digestion. I'll come in detail to why does it require digestion. Okay. Now, in holozoic nutrition, we have five steps to holozoic nutrition. The first step to holozoic nutrition is known as ingestion.
Ingestion, yes.
Okay. So ingestion is the process by which one takes the food inside. ठीक
And
है.
sir, that happens to the teeth, the tongue, the salivary gland.
एग्जैक्टली. इंजेशन के बाद से आता है हमारा डाइजेशन.
Yes.
डाइजेशन इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ ब्रेकिंग डाउन कॉम्प्लेक्स फूड इनटू सिंपलर सब्सटेंसेस. ओके.
Yes, sir. Complex starch into sugars.
एग्जैक्टली. नाउ व्हाई डू वी नीड टू डाइजेस्ट इट इज माय क्वेश्चन टू यू.
Sir, because our body can't take complex element.
Very good. But why can't it take complex things? Who transports the food?
Sir, the esophagus.
Okay, that is the food is going through the esophagus, getting digested in the body parts. Okay. And then from there, who transports the food to all the other body parts?
Sir, muscle.
No. When you get cut, something red colored starts coming out.
The blood
is generally made up of what?
Sir, white blood cells and red blood cells. And
what else? 70% of water is 70%. It is water.
Yes.
Now, does the chapati, the bread, the rice, does it dissolve in water?
No, sir.
But the chapati, the bread, the rice, when it is digested, it gets converted to glucose. Now, does glucose get dissolved in water?
Yes, sir.
Understanding? Why do we need to digest it? We convert it into simpler substances so that it can be easily absorbed. Okay? So, easy absorption can take place in the body. Okay? Now, after the absorption, the blood carries it to different parts of the body where it is used. Used for energy, used for assimilation, okay, used for growth and repair, and that is known as assimilating it, using it. And finally, the waste that could not be digested, that is not absorbed by the body, is then ingested from the body. So these are the five steps of holozoic nutrition. Okay? So let's revise it once more.
Even the holozoic nutrition also includes the alimentary canal.
Yeah. Alimentary canal would come in the mammal. Okay. Now let's look at it again. Nutrition is the process of obtaining food. Food required for energy. Food required for growth and repair. Okay. There are two types of nutrition. Autotrophic nutrition, heterotrophic nutrition. Autotrophic is where the food is made by the organism on its own. For example, green plants by the process of photosynthesis. Then we have heterotrophic nutrition, which directly or indirectly depends upon autotrophs for food. Okay. Now, why is that indirect thing mentioned? If you look at the food chain, it could be like this. Plants are directly eaten by humans, let's say. Since we are a human, we are discussing the human. But plants could be eaten by the hen, and the hen could be eaten by the human. So in the first case, the human is directly dependent upon the plant for food. In the second case, the human is indirectly dependent upon the autotrophs for food. Okay? The hen gets the energy from the plant, and the human got the energy from the hen.
Yes.
Okay? So you are a vegetarian or a non-vegetarian? Okay. So saprophytic, heterotrophic can be divided into three main types: saprophytic, parasitic, and holozoic. So what is saprophytic nutrition?
The saprophytic nutrition is when the object feeds on dead and decaying tissues.
Give me an example.
Sir, mushrooms.
Okay. What is parasitic nutrition?
The parasitic is when the object becomes it gets itself stuck to the other object's body and just takes its nutrition.
Oh, perfect. Okay, it depends upon the host for the food. And what is holozoic nutrition?
The holozoic nutrition is when the food that we take requires digestion.
Very good. Okay. Then, holozoic nutrition takes place in five steps. What are the five steps?
First, we ingest the food. Then, the digestion takes place. Then, the absorption of the complex substances break down into simpler substances. Then, we have assimilation. And then, we excrete, which is also known as digestion.
Okay. The excretion, generally we'll use it with the urine formation. Ingestion is generally with undigested food. So clear till here?